Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes. Tear of Vermillion. We just missed an item. We have Eimelle with us. Wow. So I'm gonna look around. I don't remember this person over here. Shifty Merchant. Welcome, welcome! We have anything we carry. Come on, buy something. Mixer? Yes, exactly what I was thinking. We have anything we carry, Avin says. Isn't that obvious? Ha ha ha. Don't worry about the details. What do you want? Sexy underwear? This is as the name tells. Do you want it? Ugh, says Avin. Avin, says Eimelle. No, thank you. Feather of Barking Bird. You have a keen eye. This is the feather of a legendary barking bird that no one has ever seen. Since no one has seen one, you can't tell me it's not genuine. This sounds like a scam, says Avin. Don't worry about the details. Come on, want to buy one? No. Eimelle giggles. Cane of Clumsy. This is a cane made out of naturally clumsy material. If you tap a head with this, it will make a good sound. Do you want me to try it on your head? No thanks. Miles says, what the heck is naturally clumsy material? This stuff is weird. Crystal ball? This crystal ball allows you to travel to the future. That's great, says Avin. If you stare at this crystal ball, you will lose your consciousness. When you regain consciousness, you will realize that the time has passed greatly. Oh god. Avin says, and at the same time your fatigue is gone too, right? That's right. Is that something? I don't want it. Eimelle says, I kind of want that one. Huh? Says Mile. Robe of Sage. You have a good selective eye. This is the robe of a sage, which can be seen only by the truly wise. It's got an excellent feel, and see how light it is as if it didn't exist. How's that? Ah, well, Eimelle says, it's truly amazing. The design and quality of embroidery is amazing. Uh-oh. She giggles. And she's putting him on. Earrings of Ties? Didn't see that. These are earrings filled with a lot of prayers. If you wear these pair of earrings one by one, you'll be able to be reunited even though you are apart. They also work for not getting lost. Avin, says Eimelle. I want them. Huh? We could finally reunited, right? I don't want to be separated again. But if it happened again, I'll be able to believe that we can see each other again if we both keep one of each earring. Hey, boss. I want to buy those earrings. It sounds like you are in a complicated situation. Okay, I'll give you a 100% discount. Just take them for free. Really? Are you sure? Says Avin. It's quite alright. This is only a hobby of mine anyway. Okay, we got bond earrings. Listen, guys. It's irrelevant if these items are contained with special magical power or not. The important thing is what one who possesses them believes. If you believe in each other and don't give up, your wish will come true for sure. Thanks, boss. Thank you, says Eimelle. Ha ha ha, but so you know, I won't give you any discount next time. Mal says he was a pretty nice person. That's funny. Okay. So So are they in protector? Accessory? Bond earrings, yeah. Earring given by a merchant in Beloa. The other earring is worn by Eimelle. Okay. Guess we have it on. Sorta. Beloa's silver mine is a source of revenue for the royal family of Filden, as well as the gemstone stope. Managing the silver mine and the port is an important job for Baron and his family to accomplish. Yeah, I think I've read that before. Hello, dear Eimelle. May I help you today? No, I'm taking a walk with my brother today. Oh, your brother? You are Eimelle's brother. I envy you. You have such a nice sister. I still can't believe we found her. I heard that a very pretty girl is staying at the Baron's house. Is that you by any chance? Well, I am the one who's staying at the Baron's house. That's what I thought. You are really beautiful. Stop it. Crone giggles and says, don't be so modest. You're really a beautiful girl. Gotta be embarrassing, though. Hi, Eimelle. Are you on a walk? Yes, with my brother and his friend. Eh? Is he your brother? Then I should become friends with him. I think we met a little while ago. It's nice to meet you. Humph, says Avin. Mile says, it's so easy to read the minds of these two. By the way, have you met a would-be poet at the port? He's always saying weird stuff, but don't be bothered by him. He always acts like that around cute girls. I think the Baron is a magnificent person. We are his first priority, and he's not snooty like the aristocrats at the capital. Eimelle says, yes, he is truly a splendid person. I kind of voice him as snooty, though. Talk to this jerk over here. I am the powerful merchant Mr. Garcia. Don't talk to me carelessly. Yeah, is this saying anything new? Alright. Oops. Now, I bet if we try to leave, it's Eimelle who says something. Oh, in a moment. Oh, Avin and Mile, thank you for getting rid of the monsters. And you are... aren't you staying at the Baron's house? I'm Eimelle, nice to meet you. She is, you know, my sister. So you found her. It's a good news. Okay, Mario. Then you are celebrating your reunion and touring Beloa right now? Ha ha ha. Well, something like that, Avin says. You must be off and running. But seeing you three together, it looks like an older brother is intervening in a sister's date. What? Miles says, you are right, Meister. He just doesn't give me a change to get to know her. Hey, Mile. Just kidding. Really. You jerk. Mel giggles. It's going to be a big problem in the future. If you have a boyfriend, he will go crazy. Haha, it's alright. I like my brother. Eimelle, did you hear that? Mile says, aren't you glad, Avin? You have a nice sister. Treat her well, alright? Now if we try to leave... oh wait... yeah, she does say something. Avin, why don't we go for a walk into town? Yep. I don't think he has anything new to say. Nope. Hey. Hey! Come back here. Get back here. Ah, Eimelle. It was so much fun playing hide and seek. Yeah, it was fun. Let's play it sometime again. You know what my dream is? I want to protect the town of Baloa when I grow up. It's hard to raise two boys. They never sit quietly. Eimelle says, but it's good to have siblings. Right. It would have been fun to have a brother. What, Avin? You don't like having a sister? No, that's not what I meant. Heh, just kidding. But since I was with Mile all the time, I kind of know what it's like to have a brother, though. Mile says, I know. My naughty little brother would cause a lot of trouble for me. What are you talking about? If anything, you're like my younger brother, Mile. I'm a little taller, too. Okay, whatever. Avin got a brush off from Mile, Eimelle says. Cherry says, ha ha ha, you guys are fun to be with. Either a childhood friend or siblings, it's good to have someone who can keep the same relationship over the times. Alright, this is the area she wants to go to. Oh, to control. I think we had some other place we could go, though. Is this it? Avin says. Is this the resting spot you were talking about, Eimelle? Yeah. This is a nice place, says Mile. Yeah, I can totally relax here, says Avin. Eimelle says, do you remember, Avin? There was a waterway like this running behind the cathedral. You used to skip classes and play in the water. You have a good memory, says Avin. Haha, Avin hasn't changed a bit. When we were studying under Grandpa Lemuris, he would avoid studying, too. And he always dragged me in it, even though I wanted to study. Eimelle says, oh yeah? He always made me tag along with him, too. And we were scolded by Miss Alessia a lot. Same here, says Mile. Grandpa Lemuris was so scary when he got mad. Eimelle giggles. Mile laughs. Are you guys ganging up on me? I won't forget this. Hey, Avin, says Mile. Avin, says Eimelle. I'm thirsty. I'm gonna go get something cold to drink from the tavern. Go ahead and say whatever you want about me. Haha, so this is how he deals with embarrassment, says Mile. My brother has always been like that, even when he was small. The way he says things is bad, but I know he cares about me. I guess he is really shy. Yeah, he hasn't changed a bit in that sense. Don't tell Avin this, but I think it's so funny when he gets embarrassed. Haha, I think we're going to get along really well, says Eimelle. Who's that? Shannon, oh no. I went to Newborn and finally met up with Mile, but he was gone when I woke up. I am so unlucky. Just about to see him with Eimelle. I think I hear his voice. Where art thou? Mile says, haha, and then... Mile! Guess he didn't hear that? Who is she? Who is that girl, and why is she talking to him like they're best friends? Is that his girlfriend? No way. He's my prince! Here, I brought you guys ice-cold honey water. Honey water? Avin handed a cup of honey water to Mile and Eimelle. Thanks, Avin, says Eimelle. Miles says thanks. You know what? I thought I saw Shannon, says Avin. Did you see her at all? Her at all? Miles goes, no way! You better not be kidding about something like this. I'm not kidding, I promise. She is really obsessed with you. No, no, no. Who's Shannon? Says Eimelle. No one. Let's drink our honey water while it's still cold. Avin says he may not look like it, but Mile is... Eimelle says, I see. What are you telling her? After quenching their thirst with cold honey water and relaxing for a while, they left the resting spot. They sure did. Okay. Anywhere else left to... Yeah, there's... Over here. These people. Or says, never mind about what my grandma and grandpa say. I want to mind what they say. Look at that sweet girl. If someone like you could marry my grandson, I would be so happy. Avin says, marriage? Never. I won't let her get married. Avin, she's just joking, says Eimelle. Miles says, besides, eventually Eimelle will get married. Avin says, I just meant that it's too early to even talk about marriage. I would love it if someone like you would marry my grandson, but that is a big favor to ask. I wish I could see my great-grandchild soon, but my son's not thinking about getting married at all. He's such an unfilial child. That's an interesting word. Filial being family. I guess we're done in here. Are we supposed to go back to... It smells very good, says Avin. I was about to say, we're supposed to go back to the Baron's place. Miles says, dinner should be ready soon. Should we go back to the Baron's house? No. Let's walk around a little more, says Avin. Let's just... Let's check over here for a bit. You mean a regular liner, says Eimelle? No, it's a sailing boat called the Planetos. It's not that big, but it's got the best speed. The boat will arrive by tomorrow afternoon, so why don't you enjoy some rum of Baloa now? Okay. Hoo-ah! Since my granddaughter is with me, I decided to hire an adventurer to guard us on our way to Theta. I didn't have a problem hiring an adventurer at the guild because there was someone who was going to cross the ocean anyway. I'm glad we can travel the Vault safely. I wonder what adventurer that is. Douglas again? Yeah, I guess we're done. Just... go have her at dinner. Let's go back. I'm starving after all that walking around, says Avin. Eimelle says, Avin? Huh? What is it, Eimelle? Well, there is something I have to tell you, Avin. About what? Mile says, I'll leave you guys alone. I'll help them get ready for dinner. Hey, Mile, says Avin. Mile whispers, Avin, it looks like she has something serious to tell you. Just listen to her, okay? Aw. Mile's such a good guy. Eimelle, what is it that you have to tell me? Avin, you said that you had seen Miss Alessia at Benequia Monastery. But how come you haven't asked me about my time there? Do you want to know why I left the monastery? You also met Sage Denurkin, right? Then you've heard the phrase, Durga's daughter? Yeah, he told me. I don't fully understand what it really means, though. I don't either. But I know that I'm not an ordinary girl. After we were separated, I had a lot of strange experiences. Eimelle. After we were separated, Miss Alessia and I escaped to the Benequia Monastery. And I started living there as one of the nuns. What a fate. When I first got there, I was always crying, thinking about you. I made some good friends there, and started to get used to the life in the monastery. But I still used to think of you and shed tears when I was alone. One day, I heard a voice that was talking to my heart. It sounded like our mother. The voice told me to go on a journey. She whispered to me softly that it was my destiny. And then, I set out on a journey. I didn't tell Miss Alessia, Sina, or any of my friends. I don't know if it was fate. I just thought that I might be able to find you if I traveled. After being led by the voice, I found the village. Then the voice grew louder and louder. And at the Ice Palace, something weird happened. I couldn't even tell if it was real or just a dream. The voice told me that her name was Durga. And she called me daughter. This is what Durga told me. Sooner or later, the world will be in danger of being destroyed. Then you will be the center of your destiny. However, you don't have to worry. Believe in your feelings and passion, which are hidden deep inside you, because they will release you from your destiny. Then Durga gave me a shiny crimson red crystal. That was all I could remember. When I regained consciousness, I was lying on a bed at the Baron's house, and it looks like the Baron saved me when I was unconscious somewhere on the highway. I thought that it was a dream. No, I just wanted to believe that it was a dream. But as proof that it was real, this was in my pocket. Eimelle took out a red crystal. It looks like cabeza, says Avin. It's called the sacred treasure Kurupo. It's also called the torso of Bardas. I think I should hand it over to Sir Quar in the holy capital with cabeza. Avin, can I entrust you with it? Yeah, it's probably better if you did. Avin was entrusted with Kurupo. Sounds like a disease. I'm sorry, Avin. Why are you sorry? Because I didn't intend to see you. I wanted to see you so bad, but I was afraid of involving you in my destiny. So I was going to give up on seeing you again. But when I heard your voice, I couldn't stop myself. I am really sorry. Are you nuts? Avin says, why are you apologizing? Avin softly stroked Eimelle's head. I don't know what your destiny means, but I can say one thing. My destiny was to be reunited with you. My purpose was to find you and protect you forever. But I didn't do it just for you. I did it because I wanted to. So you don't need to feel bad. Avin, I'll protect you. I will protect you no matter what lays ahead. That is my destiny. Sobbing, saying Avin again. Crying harder. After Avin calmed Eimelle down, they went back to the Baron's house. That night, everyone had a tasty Balloa-style seafood dish prepared by Lady Teresa and fell asleep happy. And the next morning, I can't believe how fast the time goes by. The day for you to depart has already come. A ferry boat will arrive around noon. Just relax until then. Thank you for everything you've done for us, says Avin. The food was delicious too, says Eimelle. Teresa says thank you. A voice yells, Baron. Oh, who's that? Cornell says, it's a state of emergency. The Silver Mine is under attack by monsters.
Oh my! How much damage is there?
Well, some miners failed to escape and are still trapped in the mining gallery.
I'll be right there. As you heard, I have to go to the Silver Mine now. Please forgive me for not sending you off.
Wait a second, says Avin. Are you going to go by yourself?
The royal family entrusted me to protect the port of Balloa and the Silver Mine. I can't leave in anyone else's hand.
He's got away with words. Miles says, but even so, it's too dangerous to go by yourself. Avin says, let us help you to pay you back for what you've done for us.
But you have to head for the Holy Capital.
We can go to the Holy Capital anytime. The miners need our help now. Eimelle, can you wait for us here? Yeah, be careful. Don't do anything reckless. Don't worry. Baron, let's go to the Silver Mine.
Avin, Eimelle, thank you. The Silver Mine is further down the mountain path, a little off of the highway. It's not too far from Balloa, so we should be able to get there soon.
Alright, Conrad, you're in the party again. So now I guess we'll have time to, a chance to throw away rare potions. A chance to actually, use his powers and stuff and throw away stuff. Avin, be careful. You too, Baron and Eimelle. Don't overdo yourselves.
Overdo. O-V-E-R-D-O.
Be careful, dear.
Don't worry. I'll be right back.
How do you put up with that guy? Please feel assured while you are out and have a safe trip. Feel assured of what? Oh, we never... Do we ever go back here? Well, there's nothing in here, okay. Do you want to put on that armor? My god, you keep finding stuff like a very frequently, but none of it's any good. Baron, is it true that the monsters appeared at the Silver Mine? Is there anything I can help you with? No. I want you guys to look after the port. Managing the cargo is also an important task. Hi, sir. Please be careful. Baron, be careful. Yeah, they're saying new stuff, so let's check in on people before we run over there. Luckily, I know where it is, because I went there. Couldn't actually get inside. You are cunning. Why can you have two such beautiful women with you? I have read that before. The Beloa Silver Mine is located in the east part of town. Let's hurry, Avin. It's not in the east part of town, it's an exit. Oh, Baron, what's wrong? Why are you in such a rush? None of your business. My job is too hard. Ugh, I'm not getting enough sleep. Hey, Avin, what's wrong? The silver mine is under attack by the monsters. Some miners may have been trapped. We are on our way to rescue them. The monsters? Are you going with them, Baron? I can't just overlook this situation because the royal family entrusted me with the mine. Be careful, all right? Oops. Oh, there's a friend with them. Where are you going? I'm very insecure because everything is so unsettled lately. Giamine, says Mile. Oh, hi, you two. Have you seen my great writer? Are you after Mr. Karamas again? I feel bad for you, says Avin. I know. It's a hard job. Please listen to my hard-earned experiences next time. Oh, hi. Who would this sturdy man be? I'm the Lord of Beloa, Conrad. Wow. Where do you live? May I come visit you sometime? My wife and I have a house near the port. Oh, so you are married. Never mind then. Okay. Mr. Was he interested in Conrad? Mr. Giamine, Miles says, we just saw Mr. Karamas. Oh, really? Where? Avin says, we saw him by the lighthouse. So it is a lighthouse, okay. But I'm pretty sure he's not there anymore. Shoot, he ran away again. How vexing. Miles says, but it looks like he has come up with some new ideas, so you should be able to receive his manuscript. Really? So you must have provided him with new ideas. You're my savior. You guys are such good kids. Quick Raven is so popular thanks to you. I really appreciate you guys. Oh, I almost forgot. Here is Quick Raven Volume 3 to show my appreciation. Sweet. Please look it over. I know this is going to be a million seller. Avin and the company obtained Quick Raven 3. That's awesome. That's why I look around all the time and constantly talk to people whenever something new happens. Like this. You guys are such good kids. Quick Raven is so popular thanks to you. I really appreciate you guys. I leave the next one entirely up to you. That's cool. I wasn't done in there. The ship's not here yet? I'm getting bored. Well, the music's exciting. The adventurers we hired should come here anytime soon, but...
But what, old man? But what?
Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. Oh, I need to talk to those people. Can we talk to this one guy here?
Baron, is it true that the monsters appeared at the Silver Mine?
I've never heard anything like that, but what in the world is going on?
Lord Conrad, there are incidents with the monsters occurring often. I feel anxious for some reason.
Because I wonder why these two things are connected.
The monsters attacked the Silver Mine this time? Baron, I'm scared.
Is it true that the Silver Mine was attacked? We'll gather young men and go out to support.
It's not for sure yet. I want you all to wait here.
Baron, are you going out again?
We appreciate your hard work for Baloa, but don't make Lady Teresa worry, please.
I will remember that.
Baron, is it true that the Silver Mine was attacked?
It's true. I'm on my way to aid the people there.
Thank you.
Here it is to cheer you up.
A bartender offered a cup to Baron.
Gulp!
Woohoo!
Good luck, Baron.
I'll never forgive the evil deed.
What did he give him?
That was our specialty rum. It works well, as you see.
The evil deed.
Alright, so I talked to these people.
Ah, Lord Conrad, please play with me.
I'm sorry, but I have some emergency to take care of. You stay inside, okay?
Oh, okay. I don't know what's going on, but good luck on your work.
Let's play together when you're done.
Baron, what's going on? My mom said I can't leave the house.
You shush.
Are you going to the Silver Mine, Baron? Please be cautious.
I don't think that guy has anything new to say. Oh. Nope, I wanted to talk. I wanted to interact with the cat. I've had that before. Oh yeah, this guy. Nope.
Baron, below a silver mine is...
Yes, I know. Avin and Mile will cooperate with us from now on. We are going to check the circumstance of the mine.
Aye, sir. Please be careful.
Is he? Please be careful. I pray for the fortunes of war.
Okay, then. You want to get rich, I don't know. Alright, so next episode, guys, heading for the silver mine to try to help these workers. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always seek adventure.